guys consider my journey here to have actually started about 5 years ago. 5 years ago, I had zero plan. I left high school with the intent to travel and join the Royal Air Force, which, looking back now, is not exactly how it came to be. And instead, I find myself 2 years later after that point, attending Quinnipiac, playing Division I rugby. And not exactly what I had in mind, but something that I was excited about, but also absolutely terrified about. So many people have asked, like, how on earth I found Quinnipiac, and often I just kind of chuckle and say, well, we kind of found each other through an amazing individual who has been probably one of my biggest supporters and one of the most selfless and generous people that I have had the pleasure to meet. Owen Davis, you are absolutely incredible, and I thank you for everything that you have done for me. Thank you for your support. You are the reason that I am standing here where I am today, and I have been so fortunate to have met you and embark on this journey with me. You've been amazing, and again, I can't thank you enough. And to Jane, another one of my biggest supporters, thank you for always having a blanket ready for me after every single game and engulfing me in one of your biggest, warmest hugs ever. Thank you for your endless love. Thank you for your home-cooked chili, which is probably going to be missed dearly at all the tailgate spreads. Thank you for getting excited with me about every little accomplishment that I have at school, and thank you for staying with me throughout the night and waking me up every 4 hours and feeding me animal crackers and my medication after ACL surgery. I cannot thank you enough for what you've done for me, and I'll treasure all of our memories, and I hope this is just the beginning, and I hope you've just enjoyed the journey as much as I have and are excited for it to continue. I also want to thank every other family that has embraced me and taken me under their wing and taken care of me throughout my journey here. Special shout out to the Halgersons for everything that you've done, and all the Tillamook cheese, and letting me crash every family dinner that what you've gone on when you've come out here. But truly thank you to all families, and despite being so far from home, I've never felt lost because of all of you, so thank you again.
I'll be the last one standing. This is our home. This is our ground. We defend it. We don't let anybody come in here and dictate how the game is played. We play it our way, and we show them what we're made of. That's it. And we try and do that as best we can away as well. And we've done a pretty good job of it this year. But you know, home is home. Like, that's your ground, and you defend it.
To my own parents, thank you for not thinking me insane and just completely mad for going on this random and blind adventure to Quinnipiac in the United States. In all honesty, my parents and I had zero idea about what we were getting ourselves into. Like, I just rang mom and dad one day and was like, hey, I'm applying for a university in the States and gonna go play rugby. And they're like, what? So thank you for just having blind faith in me and the journey that I was about to embark on, because in all honesty, now looking back, I knew nothing. But man, it's been an adventure. It was a massive gamble, but it was a massive gamble that paid off. So thank you for everything, and it was absolutely amazing to see you last October, like, after everything that we've been through, and from all the Christmases that I've come back and told you about everything that I've done, the classes that I've taken, the games that I've played, the championships that we've won, to telling you all about that, and then for you to come over in October and actually witness it, I have never been so happy. And one of my greatest memories will be of when we were playing at Army. As Emily, it might have been you who had gone for a runaway try, and I looked over in the stands and I saw my mum jumping up and down, clapping her hands, cheering her on as loudly as she possibly could. And oh my gosh, I've never seen my mum get that excited at a rugby game before. That was so exciting. And to be fair, I've never seen her so tense before the following week when we were playing Central Washington at home. Thankful for both of you for coming over and meeting my Bobcat family. And finally, to my fellow seniors and teammates, thank you for keeping me sane. Thanks for pushing me, as well as putting up with me. Thanks for all the memories, laughs, inappropriate jokes, and conversations. And thanks for being my Bobcat family. I'm gonna miss you. Bye.
Flora, your team seemed pretty fired up coming out of the halftime break. What did you guys talk about in the huddle?
I mean, we know exactly what we needed to do. It was just executing it. We had enough energy. We were battling the wind for the first half. We were like, nope, we're going with the wind this time. And they are going to have Dartmouth has battled with the wind. So we were just like, we feel good. We feel great. We know exactly what we're going to do. We have great energy levels. And we just hit it from the get-go.